that began as a way to connect women of color and empower them through reading while also introducing them to black writers, but that's not all.
Tell us more. We're joined by founder Jewel Z. Good morning.
Good morning. Hello.
Where are you at right now?
I live in Charlotte, North Carolina.
Well, hi. Why did you create this club?
So I've been a YouTube content creator for the past decade, and I realized there's just a vast landscape of misinformation and really disinformation that was proliferating through the black digital landscape, especially with the rise of the Trump era in 2016. And so often when we're pushing back against this misinformation, it's like, oh, go read this book because it's already been written. But like, reading really isn't accessible, nor is reading fun when you're like, for a lot of people, when you're doing it by yourself. Uh-huh. And I kept seeing like theoretical academic texts being recommended as a pushback to like these ahistorical takes. But I'm like, there's a reason why this misinformation spreads so fast, because it's coming through video content and Vine and now TikTok.
Yeah.
And we need to do more to make that sort of, you know, text more accessible by putting it into different content streams. So that's what the book club does.
So what type of books are you proposing or suggesting, or what type of books have you, your group already have read?
So we do two tracks of reading. We do a general reading track where we do fiction. And we tend to we map the reading out over a year. And we think about like, you know, 2020 was a hectic, hectic year. And so we try to think about where our readers going to be at, what's happening, particularly in the American landscape, mm-hmm. And what books would fit in and be, you know, is it school season? Are they going to have kids in school? Is it the winter time? So we did The Vanishing Half as shown here in December. And, you know, picking books that kind of fit into the lifestyles that we might have. Okay. And then we have an exploration track where we read academic texts, and those we kind of build on social theory that we're working through. So we've been doing a lot of reading around, obviously, the intersectionality, black feminism, actually explaining what black feminism is. We got into differently abled and able-bodiedness, reading pleasure activism last year. And currently we're doing Playing in the Dark, which is Whiteness in the Literary Imagination by Toni Morrison. And then we're reading Black Sun, which is an indigenous sci-fi read.
Okay.
That goes over like, you know, gender, sexual identity, and indigenous rights.
How many people are in your club? Have you been keeping track?
Yeah, we currently have about 3,500 members.
Whoa.
You know, a couple hundred every month read along with us. It's like, you know, touch and go here, but you know, we're going to keep pushing through and keep doing the work and, you know, just trying to make reading more accessible.
Okay. All right. So what's the website there in case anyone's interested?
Well, yeah, y'all are showing the website. Definitely go drop us a donation because it takes a lot of money to do this kind of work. But it's Smart Brown Girl, singular, smartbrowngirl.com. All identities of people are welcomed. We just really center, you know, women of color and black women specifically. But obviously, okay. We're now getting into reading about, we've been doing a lot of reading around gender identity and non-binary people. So,
okay. You
know, really trying to just expand the equity for all different types of identities and making a safer world for all of us.
Wonderful. Jewel Z, thank you so much.
Thank you. Have a good rest of your day.
You take care.
Yes.
Bye.
All right, UC Davis, Horse Barn is on Baby Watch. The House Barn, Horse Barn is an undergraduate teaching facility for students.
Yeah, now earlier this week, Kulisa made a quick stop to find out more as the Baby Watch continued.